Hello guys, I am a student from AISSM Society and today I am going to tell you how to connect BeagleBone and how to format it. Firstly, we will take a brief introduction of how the BeagleBone looks. Here is the image of the BeagleBone. Here we see there are many parts of the BeagleBone. So in this diagram we can see the brief description of parts on the BeagleBone. Here is the serial debugger, here is the DC power and here is the Ethernet cable, and here there are four LEDs. Below four LEDs there is an USB where we connect the BeagleBone through PC through USB. Here is the processor of the BeagleBone, which is ARM Cortex A8 processor. Here there is a RAM which is of 512 DDR3, and it has internal memory of 2 GB. Also we can insert a micro SD card. The slot is present here. We can connect the BeagleBone to desktop by using micro HDMI, and there is a USB host also. It is present here. And next step, we will connect the BeagleBone. Firstly, we connect the BeagleBone through USB. Here we are having the USB port. Whenever BeagleBone is booting, there are four lights. These four lights depict. To connect a BeagleBone on a macOS, there is a step. We need to first install SSH on the PC. So next step, you can say that we have to type this command like SSH 192.168.7.2-L and root, where SSH depicts the keygen, where 192.168.7.2 depicts the USB port IP address, and -L is the option and root is the username. So the BeagleBone is connected now. Now we are going to install a Debian OS on a BeagleBone board through micro SD card. So basically we will need to download the image from the beaglebone.com/latest-images. It contains many images, so we are selecting the Debian image which can be installed on 2 GB micro SD card. The image is this. Next, we will extract the image. While extracting the image, we are using macOS to mount the image on the micro SD card. So now we are using the unarchiver. This software extracts the .exe file, that is a 7-zip file, to then image file. Next, we will right click the file and open with the unarchiver. So this unarchiver software will extract the image on the desktop. It takes some time to extract the image. Here the image is extracted on the desktop. Now we will mount this image on the micro SD card. So for mounting the image, we are using the PI Filer software. In PI Filer, firstly, don't insert the micro SD card in the micro. Next, we will select the image. We go browse the location and select the image file, not the .exe file. Now whenever it's prompts for inserting the SD card, next we will insert the SD card in my MacBook. So we can continue. It is looking for your SD card. Later it asks that should the micro SD card be erased? So we can continue and we can confirm that erase SD card. While authentication, enter your password which is set for the user. Next, the PI file will erase the whatever is present on the SD card and will install the new image on the BeagleBone. Next we have skipped the middle time and the image is successfully mounted on the SD card. Press quit. Noise on the micro SD card. Now we are going to put this image on the BeagleBone board. So firstly insert the micro SD card in the micro SD slot which is present here. Insert the micro SD card in the micro SD slot present here. Then we should supply the power. So we are using now USB cable instead of using the power source. We will just supply some power to the BeagleBone board through USB. So while booting, now we will need to press the boot button present here. This is the boot button. We are going to constantly press it. Now we will remove the cable and we will reinsert it in the same slot. So now the boot sequence will change and the boot will be from the micro SD card. Next we will leave the button and the OS will be booted on the BeagleBone. After 20 to 25 minutes the image will be booted. And after successfully boot, these four LEDs will be off. Next, we can remove the USB cable and reinsert it and check on the desktop whether it is connected or not.